Thanks, Fizan, and welcome all to the session on integrated operation theaters. So I have a difficult role today to keep you awake after lunch, and I'll try to make it interesting, and I'll try to start with the journey of how operation theaters have evolved over time, and now what kind of operation theaters are prevalent, what kind of operation theaters are getting built across different countries. And then I'll go into detail of what is modular OTs consist of, and what are the levels of integration of operation theaters that is happening across. Okay, so when I say evolution of the ORs, I'll start with 1800s. So this is an interesting image that I have shown here. One of the first operation theaters. So when I say theaters, it was actually a theater where people sit around the OT and see. So one of the first operating rooms, the surgical table was a wooden table, and the surgical light was a gas light. And it is interesting to see what were the regulations of the theater. So the board said that apprentices and dressers of the surgeon who operate are to stand round the table. So they have defined the rules of the theater. The dressers of the other surgeons are to occupy the three front rows. The surgeon pupils are to take their places in the row above, and visitors are admitted by permission of the surgeon. So you see, there is no infection control, there is no the scrubs, nothing. So this is a literal theater. So when we go forward in 1900s, we see antisepsis was this time accepted, so which led to people wearing gowns. So this is 1924 in Toronto, and washing of hands was accepted, and electrical lighting was added. But you still see there are windows, big windows, so that light can come in from outside. We move forward, 1970s. So what happened now? So the lighting system developed. And so the gas cylinders for anesthesia were there, oxygen were there, and lighting system developed. So you see OT lights. So these are halogen lights which developed. And today, there are lots and lots of equipments inside the operation theater. But there are systems which integrate these kind of equipments. So if I say, what is integration? So integrated ORs, the first known concept was developed in 1992 in US West Coast and East Coast, where they started putting things on carts, and they starting in wiring them together so that they can be controlled from one place. So this was from 1992, and now we see 2016 or 2017. So this is what is happening now. You see there are no wires on the floor. OT table, the wiring is from the base. Lights, wiring is from the top. There are pendants on which equipments can be mounted, and everything is connected. All the audio signals, video signals of the OT, all the packs, HMS, we had a session on HMS, everything is integrated. We have controls on the walls, we have displays on the monitors, and we see integration in everything. So does this benefit an OT? How does it benefit the OT? You see, there are no wires on the floor. So There is more efficiency, there is more infection control, there are better equipment control. So you have surgeon ergonomics. The monitor is on a particular height of the doctor. Unko, they don't have to bend their neck for particular cases. So I have taken some photographs of how OTs are being built. So this is Gold Coast Private Hospital in Australia. Then we have hybrid suits being built. So there are CMs, there are monitors, there are OT lights. You see here. So these are photographs I am running you through. So now, what is integration? I'll define the integrated operation theater concept. So the integration system, the first level, the basic level is you build a modular OT. You build proper wall paneling, proper windows, the door system, the flooring, scrub station, control panel, and wiring. So you build a proper modular OT. This is the base, the basic thing which is required for integration. What integration encompasses, what it actually is this. It is connecting all the things to a central system. It is connecting the equipments, it is controlling the devices, and it is managing the workflow. So this is integration. Now I'll show you a video after two or three slides which tells you, which shows you actually how a doctor enters an OT and he performs the case, and how he the post-operative care instructions, for example, he gives. So that workflow management is actually integration. Then we have the level three, which is media management. So for example, you have an operation theater, you're doing a surgery. All the surgeries can be live recorded, and there is an iPad app through which you can have all the surgeries on your iPad. You can have all the surgeries on the FTP server. You want to email it, you want to print it, everything is possible on that particular moment. Right when you're performing that surgery. There are ways and means by which an operation theater can be equipped. You take a mic, you wear a mic during a surgery, you want to capture an image, capture cystic duct image. The image captures, you want to annotate it, you want to email it, you can do it right there. There are ways possible. I'll show you how. Then we have the PACS connectivity, the EMR, EHR connectivity. So you have all the diagnostic lab reports, you have all the patient health reports. You can take it, you can put it from the hospital server, and you can show it on the monitors across. You're doing a surgery and you want the X-ray to be superimposed on the video in the monitor in front of your eyes. The surgery will go on, a small inset will show you the X-ray of the patient. So that is also possible in integrated operation theaters. I'll come back to this slide. So I'll show you the video first. Just notice the entire workflow which is happening. The patient enters the OT. All the patient health records from the HMS can be imported into the system.
Device preset.
So there are multiple doctors in a particular OT. They all have their settings preloaded. Just have to click the photograph and all the settings will load. There are WHO checklists inbuilt into the digital system. There are audio visual signals which is device on the device control.
Lights, camera, action.
Light source activated. Camera white balance complete. Insufflator activated.
For anatomical visualization.
Device
standing
control.
Comfortably and
clarity.
Seeing the monitor on eye level.
Device control. Capture image. Cystic duct. Device control. Insufflator. High flow.
Insufflator high flow.
He's controlling the equipment through his voice. Insufflator flow was increased.
It's closing time.
Light source standing by.
And the surgery was done. and all the surgery was recorded real time into his iPad. He can annotate on it, write on it, and if he wants to email it, or for example, show it to a patient's relative or email it for post-operative care instructions, he can email it directly. So this was basically a glimpse of how an operation theater, the workflow happens in an integrated operation theater. So right from the HMS integration into your OT and into all the displays, right from when you're doing the surgery, in the inset you have the X-ray images, then you have the device controls, can be through voice, can be on the wall panel, a 42-inch wall panel on your OT, in your OT, or can be on a computer monitor, which can be placed inside the OT or in a dead space or in a control room. So these all are possible options. So how does this help you? So actually, is integration required? What benefits it provides? So these are some points I tried to capture. So see, whenever you are integrating your operation theater, you are building a thing which gives you efficiency. You are doing 10 surgeries per day, for example. I'm taking an example. And you have particular time for turnovers. You have particular time of doing all the settings. You have particular time for the post-operative settings. All these things, the workflow is minimized so that you get more surgery time per day. Your OT efficiency, what does that mean? More revenue per day. So for example, if they're all wires on the floor, they're equipments. So between surgeries, you have to clean these equipments. You have to remove equipments, clean it, put it back properly, then do the next surgery. Here, an integrated operation theater reduces that time. So we have studies which says the iSuit provides the integrated operation theater provides an average reduction of 11 minutes in turnover times of OTs. उन्होंने अपनी सेटिंग पे क्लिक किया, नाम पे क्लिक किया, ऑल द सेटिंग्स एक्टिवेटेड. सो इट इज नॉट टेकिंग 5 मिनट्स. वो चेकलिस्ट हाथ से लेकर नहीं आ रहे हैं. इट इज ऑन द सिस्टम. यू कैन जस्ट क्लिक प्रेस द सिस्टम चेकलिस्ट एंड डिजिटल रिकॉर्डिंग इज देयर. डिजिटल प्रूफ इज देयर ऑफ द रिकॉर्ड डॉक्यूमेंट्स. सो दिस इज हाउ इंटीग्रेटेड ऑपरेशन थिएटर्स गिव यू मोर सर्जरी टाइम पर डे. देन इट इज अ गुड टूल फॉर कनेक्टिविटी. सो योर OT is connected real time, all time, to the next OT, for example. Aapko koi surgery supervise karni hai, which is going on in the next OT, and a junior surgeon is performing that surgery. You can take one monitor of your surgery, and you can take another monitor of his surgery. And you can supervise. Aapko inset mein lena hai. You have picture in picture. Ek picture aapki surgery, you're doing that surgery, and the second picture is the different surgery, and you are on a call through that system with the other OT. आपको ट्रांसप्लांट सर्जरी का कोई ओटी इक्विपमेंट ओटी प्रिपरेशन करना है. सो ऑल दैट कैन बी डन विद दिस. यू आर इन सिटिंग इन योर लाउंज, योर केबिन, एंड यू वांट टू सी दैट सर्जरीज आर हैपनिंग ओके. यू कैन टेलीकास्ट द सर्जरीज टू योर केबिन रियल टाइम, ऑल टाइम. यू कैन हैव द सर्जरीज ऑन योर मोबाइल फुल डे, 24 आवर्स. योर ओटी कैन रन ऑन योर द ओटी कैमराज कैन रन ऑन योर मोबाइल डिवाइसेस. सो देर आर लॉट ऑफ हॉस्पिटल्स विच आर डूइंग इट. आई विल टेक few examples. AIIMS Delhi has integrated operation theaters to the level of this media management and desktop connectivity. Then there is a telemedicine center in Lucknow, which is SGPGI. Heard of it? SGPGI. So it is the national telemedicine leading center. So there are doctors which are leading these telemedicine initiatives across the country. So Dr. S.K. Mishra is there. So what he does is, I'm quoting this example because how we can go advanced in this technologies. So he has made a complete video wall room, and he telecasts the surgeries live into that room for his students to see all day. And he has all the surgeries on his mobile so that he can supervise the surgeries. So that is the level of telemedicine, of this integration connectivity they are performing. So AIMS Neuro Center in Delhi has this. Then there are private hospitals, Fortis, Medanta, Apollo. All these hospitals are integrating into operation theater so as to increase the efficiency and so as to attract talent. So integrated operation theater gives you better surgical experience. Better surgical experience, kya hota hai? You get good doctors on board, good surgeons on board. And good surgeons on board can further lead to attracting more patients for the hospital. So that is a marketing kind of strategy for hospitals that they adopt. That we have state-of-the-art integrated operation theaters. I'll go ahead. So I'll just walk you through whatever was shown in the video. So what are the advantages? The first application that was done in the video was importing patient records. The second system was done is they uploaded the surgeon's profile, and this profile is on the cloud. So if you are doing surgeries in two hospitals or three hospitals, you can import your settings from the cloud into the system. Then there are WHO checklists. There are printers attached. You get this checklist done. There's a digital record. You take printouts on your letterhead. Then there is control of devices. I'll not say voice control, because voice control is not the only thing. It is a thing which is jazzy. It looks good. But there are also options of controlling it through touch panels. Then we have access on the desktops. And then we have broadcasting live surgery exhibitions anytime you want. So if you want ki kal mujhe koi CME karni hai and mujhe apne conference room mein wo telecast karni hai, you can do it tomorrow. If you want to telecast it to a hotel, you can do it. If you want to telecast it to another country, you can do it. So there are all capabilities built into your OT. So your OT is connected. So now I'll take some other examples. So how this helps in surgical routine. So there is a doctor which is saying, Dr. Sharma from OT5 would like to consult. So this junior doctor is saying, so the senior doctor says, okay, I'm doing my surgery. Put OT5 on picture-in-picture mode on this monitor. Let's see what's going on. So you see this monitor, the normal thing is happening, and in the inset, there's another OT image which is coming, and you can be on the call. The speakers are in the room also. If you want to have a mic and headset, you can have that also connected. The second situation, a junior surgeon is facing a challenge in some operation. So you are outside, you're not in the hospital, or you're somewhere else. So I'm outside the OT. Let me connect the surgery on my iPad and see what is happening. So not on phone, but not on call, but you can have it live on the iPad. Then if the best thing is you connect all the things. You connect the C-arm, you connect the microscope, the PACS, anything can be connected. All video signals, audio signals, should be connected and can be displayed on any kind of monitors. So resident surgeons are performing the case today. So let me keep connected to them from my cabin. And I am seeing the surgeries from my cabin live. So this is, for the next situation is, this is a rare complication in surgery. So what I'll do is, let me telecast this right away to my students. So for example, there is a medical college, and the students are in their hostel, and there are LCDs in their canteen, for example. And you are doing a surgery, and you want to show them the surgery right away. Just give them a call. I'm connecting this surgery to your canteen's LCD, your canteen's TV. Just watch this immediately. So they go and watch this. So good for medical education. So this was a very brief introduction about integrated operation theaters. Because this is a post-lunch session, I am not going to extend this theoretically more. So I introduced you an integrated operation theater. I introduced what all uses it can do. I'll now request, if you have any questions, any queries on integrated operation theaters, we'll have it. Yes. So. Yes, Stryker does all the integrations. What we have is a routing device, which has input cards and output cards. So all the equipments, so if I show this, all the equipments, right from OT light, encephalator, laparoscopic camera, microscope, C-arm, PAC system, a 4K monitor, a 3D monitor, everything can be connected to the input side. Everything is connected to the input side, and then the displays are connected to the output side. You want C-arm image, these are connected in during making the operation theater. They are connected to the integration system, and you connect them to an output signal anytime you want. So we give you, we integrate all the devices. We integrate all these through a touch panel and control device, and we give you the power to switch anytime. So there are list of inputs and there are list of outputs. You click on laparoscopic camera, you click on monitor 3, it goes to monitor 3. You click on laparoscopic camera, go to monitor 1, go to surgeon's room, go to a video conference hall, go to another hotel. All the displays are on the left side, on the right side. All the inputs are on the left side. It's very, very simple like that.
Any HL7 system can be connected, or you need any specific, because there would be, you know, just and there would be some. You can connect any HL7 system.
Yes. So that is the best part. We have an open architecture. What we do is we give only 18 slots, empty slots, and based on the devices you have or you are getting, we connect those devices into that slots. We have slots for all division devices which are present in the industry, all. And the best part is, as soon as new devices get added, we only have to get a slot ready for that, and we connect it to our system. So last quarter only, we introduced 4K. So 4K is an upcoming thing. Laparoscopic cameras, displays are getting into 4K monitoring. So we don't have that much 4K inputs right now, but we have 4K monitors which are coming into the system. So we are right now in upscaling. We are connecting the 4K monitors, but we are upscaling the image to 4K. That capability is also what we are doing.
What about this and all that? That also is your responsibility, or you leave it to the software to?
No. So the HMS, we don't develop. We allow you to integrate into your workflow.
Okay.
So you want to take the data from HMS and show it anywhere, we can do that. We don't make the HMS, we integrate it. So there are separate vendors for HMS, and we work closely with them, what all software requirements, software they're developing, input, output, the data they'll generate, and the data that can be captured, that can be integrated into the system. We take that and we integrate into the system.
So now when you were saying that and all that, so that
email can be possible through our system. Emailing, making calls, video calls, telephone calls is possible through this system. Yes, they are all part of our system. So emailing, media management. So there was the second level was media management. All the media management is level 2. We can do that. Any cap on?
Chargeable as per the numbers of users?
Users, you mean profiles of surgeons? No, so there are 500 profiles which can be inbuilt. They are already there. And if you want, because 500 we have not come across as of now, so we have a lot of installations. 500 maybe, in single OT, 500 profiles are sufficient. And they are not chargeable even if you want more. We have 18 by 18 slots, so why are these slots required? So as I said, there are different audio-visual inputs which are there in an OT. There is the laparoscopic camera. I'll just count it for you. There is the wall camera which can be integrated. There is a microscope. There is a C-arm. Then there is a PAC system, HMS system. So you don't require 18 inputs on a go. So we have provided some extra inputs. For example, you want to have 4 videos on one monitor. You can have 1, 2, 3, 4 videos. 4 inputs can be directly taken into one. That is why separate cards we have provided. So we can do that, but generally what happens is we have to give multiple controls of the system then. Right. So the first operation theater or the second operation theater can control the routing of devices. So we generally prefer to give control to one operation theater for one particular integration. We can do that for two operation theaters
with
also.
Two controls and splitting of the
splitting of the control. Generally, we don't do, but the capability allows us to do that.
It can be done.
And another thing is, we are over fiber cable inside the operation theater. We are not connecting the devices to the control system through IP. Mm-hmm. So there is no lag, and there are no chances of failure, because if you have IP and you are having one single controller for example, two OTs, three OTs, and they are all transmitting the signal through IP. So there are encoders at every device. If there's a laparoscopic camera, it will have an encoder. The control system will have decoder. Then it encodes, and the monitor will decode. So there are fail points at every system, which we are avoiding by giving a direct fiber cable to the system.
Video signal you are routing through the what types of cable, whether it is a fiber optic cable or it is a
the type of cable is fiber optic, but the signals we can take DVI, HDMI, S-video, composite, any signal on earth which is inside the operation theater.
So you have to provide encoders also with the fiber optic cable?
No. Fiber optic cable will not have encoders. The IP system, if it is converting the laparoscopic video image to IP, mm-hmm. then sending it somewhere, it will require an encoder. So if we want to send it outside the OT, we do it on IP. Agar aapko kisi aur hospital bhejna hai image ko usi time, so we do it on IP. But inside the OT, encoders and decoders are not required.
Right. So fiber optic cable and maybe a 4K cable or SDI cable or 3SDI cable or SDI cable, they have SDI and SDI cable have limitations of transmission. They have limitation of upscaling. So for video transmission, you use SDI cables or fiber optical? That was my question.
Fiber optics.
It can be upgraded to 5K and more capability in yes, future also. Yes.
Fiber optics. Yes. Any other questions? So in India, as of now, we have more than 100 installations. Internationally, we have more than 10,000 installations. So if I say which all hospitals, some major hospitals, I told you AIIMS, which is a big institute and takes the best technology. I'm talking about government. The second is SGPGI. If I talk about corporates, they are small single hospitals which have taken this, and there are chains. So Apollo Chennai, Fortis Delhi, Gurgaon. Then we have Medanta, Gurgaon. Then we have small hospitals like Bharti Hospital. Last quarter only, we had Kiran Hospital in Gujarat, which was inaugurated by Modi ji. So we are developing a lot of OTs across India on this platform. Yes, so good question. Good question. So what the best part in integration is, it should match your need at that particular time, and it should be upgradable whenever you want it. So we are not controlling, we are not giving you, say, level 3, level 4 on the start. We'll say, if you feel ki aapko economically viable banne tak, you want to have a future ready thing, so you take level 1. If, for example, you make only a modular OT and make it integration ready, then after 6 months, after a year, add the first component to it, connectivity component to it if you want. After 1 year, add the iPad component to it. After 2 years, add maybe 4K and all these things which you have developed into that capability. So economical viable option we are giving through an open architecture, and actually why it is viable. Because in a small city, people tend to get attracted to good hospitals. there is peer pressure, there is competition among hospitals. So if you become the first hospital to get a state-of-the-art thing, you attract more patients. So that is how it becomes viable.
Now, for a level one setup, what would be, you know, what in terms of costing, approximately what are we talking of and what range?
So, so level one, I am not touching because level one is a civil work. Civil work, Stryker does not do directly. Stryker outsources it, or you can have your own modular vendors. Level two, which is the connectivity. So this connectivity, basic approximate costing is around 50 lakhs for the connectivity system. So there are OT lights, tables, these are all separate. The pendants, these are all separate things. Connectivity, video recording, all these things. Workflow management, video routing, so we'll give you the system at around 50 lakhs.
Y'all, you know, like most equipment manufacturers, y'all have your financing schemes, or that's, you know, that is.
We are not very strong in financing. I'll be frank with you, but we can help you arrange that. We have done it through local. Our sales representatives help you get it arranged, but directly from the company, we don't have it right now.
And what is a full-blown system which will cost approximately?
I'll take examples which we have sold recently. So AIMS Neuro Center was approximately 3.8 CR. Sorry? That is not for me to comment.